What a joy it is to come and share with you again these devotional moments. In the 22nd chapter of the Gospel of Luke, Jesus leaves the upper room and goes out to the Mount of Olives. He comes to this very special place called Gethsemane, and he takes with him into the Garden of Gethsemane Peter, James, and John, the same three disciples who had been with him on the Mount of Transfiguration and had seen him in all of his glory. He now brings with him into the garden to see him in his gloom, to remind us that life has two sides, glory and gloom. He says to these three disciples, "Watch with me while I go yonder and pray." And he goes apart from them, and he kneels and he prays this prayer, "O my Father, if it be possible, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done." I want to remind you that life has its bitter cups of sickness and suffering and sorrow, bitter cups of tragedy and trials and troubles, bitter cups of pain and problems. Life has many bitter cups. How do you handle life's bitter cups? Jesus prays, "O my Father, if it be possible, remove this cup." And this was no sham of a prayer he prayed. Jesus knew that if it were the Father's will, this cup could be removed directly, that God could take it out of his hands. To remind us, we serve a God who can remove life's bitter cups, that no situation is either helpless or hopeless when Jesus gets involved. But what are we to do when, like our Lord, we prayed and asked the Lord to remove the cup, but we sense that God is not going to remove the cup directly? When you read this story, you discover that Jesus prayed this prayer not once, but three times. For I've discovered that if God does not remove the cup directly, God can remove the cup by transforming its contents. He doesn't have to take the cup out of your hand. He can simply change what's inside of the cup. He can transform cups of hatred into cups of love, cups of doubt into cups of faith, cups of fear into cups of courage. He can transform, he can simply change what's inside of the cup. But what are we to do when we've prayed and we've asked the Lord to remove the cup? He does not remove it directly, neither does he change its contents. I've discovered that thirdly and ultimately, the Lord has a way of removing the cup by sharing it with us. Paul had a thorn in his flesh. He prayed and asked the Lord three times to remove that thorn, and God's answer was no, no, no. But ultimately, God told him, "My grace is sufficient. My strength is made perfect in your weakness." And God has a way of removing the cup by sharing it with us, by holding our hand, by walking with us in the storm, by seeing us through our struggles. The Bible says, after Jesus had prayed this prayer a third time, there appeared unto him an angel from heaven strengthening him. When you can take your crisis, your bitter cups, and place it in the Lord's hands, and ultimately say to the Lord, "Not my will, but thine be done," God will provide you with your own personal strengthening angel, one who will strengthen and stand by you in times of crisis, in times of struggle, in times of trial. Look to the Lord when you're faced with life's bitter cups and put it all in his hands. Let us pray. Gracious God, our Father, we thank you afresh and anew for being a God who strengthens us, for being a God who is with us even when we're faced with life bitter cups. Our prayer is that you will speak to that person or persons who's struggling with some bitter cup right now, and let them know that your grace is sufficient. For we pray and we ask it all in the wonderful name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. I want to remind you of our prayer calls Wednesday mornings at 7 a.m. and then again Saturday evenings at 6 p.m. Don't forget, Sunday mornings at 8:45 will be our Sunday school review, followed by 9 a.m. worship. May the Lord bless you now, and you have a great day in the Lord.